Good evening, viewers. We want to take you through this topic of electoral processes and functions of governments in other parts of the world. This topic comes from the paper one topic of Kenya, where we looked at the formation, structure, and functions of government of Kenya. We will be labored to look at how governments are run in other parts of the world and probably compare how the systems of government used in various countries. We will have a case study of the United States of America, USA, Great Britain, and India. Now you can look at those are American presidents, the current Mr. Barack Obama, who has just left office, and the first president, Washington, George. That is the White House, the seat of power, Washington, D.C., USA. The United States of America undergoes an electoral process which involves, number one, convening of elections at the following levels. In the U.S., elections are convened at presidential level, at congressional level, at state levels, and at local government levels. Those are the levels at which elections are conducted in the U.S. The process begins with registration of voters, and only those who meet voting requirements are registered. Number two, nomination process of candidates done through the party platform. And those candidates thus embark on election campaigns. And the campaigns are conducted through television, through advertisements, number three, through endorsements, and number four, by way of canvassing. These are methods of campaigns. And the campaigns are funded through the public coffers and also through private funding. We continue the US. Voting takes place at designated polling stations, and after voting, election officials count the votes. In the case of presidential elections, a method called electoral college system is used, where countries are allocated a number of college votes, and a winning president must garner at least 270 college votes to be declared president. Then we have levels of elections. There are two-year elections done for the House of Representatives. Then governors are elected for 4 years term, and senators go for 6 years. These are levels of elections in the US. Then the following conditions must be met by a person who wants to become member of parliament, MP, in the House of Representatives: 25 years of age and above, must be a citizen of USA and has lived there for 7 years, must be a resident of the state he wants to represent. These are the basic requirements for member of parliament. To become a senator, you must have lived in the US for 9 years as a citizen and 30 years of age and above, and must be a resident of the state you want to represent in the Senate. Then, if you look at presidential elections, the president must be a citizen of the US by birth for maximum legality. He must be 35 and above and must have resided in the US in the last 14 years. Elections are based on universal suffrage, which means anybody who has attained voting age is allowed to vote. In the US, elections is conducted such that political parties can compete for power. And the major political parties in the US are the Republican Party, which has produced great men like Donald Trump,
The Democratic Party, which has produced great men like Bill Clinton, Barack Obama, the Green Party, and the Libertarian Party of the US. Those are the main political parties. You can be asked to identify two political parties that compete for power in the US. Then, what is the role played by political parties in the US? Political parties help in fundraising. Number two, party levels are useful to the voters because it helps them to choose the candidates. Parties are avenues through which candidates can seek for political office. And parties are useful for purposes of accountability, and they are avenues through which voters, their wishes and opinions can be passed through. Including views and opinions of nominees are also looked at through the party. Again, the following procedure is looked at for the presidential nominations and elections. The president is elected after every 4 years and can go for a 2-4 year term in office, which means a president cannot be president in the US for 8 maximum years. A party conducts what is called party primaries, where delegates are chosen for the national convention. Then, these primaries are conducted such that the party conventions are done between February and not later than June on the year of elections. The parties nominate and sponsor their presidential candidate. After being cleared by the party, the candidates must pick a person, a lady or a man, to become a running mate. And this running mate must be approved by the party delegates at the national convention. There is selection of the president by an electoral college, which I've told you. Any person must garner at least 270 votes. And these votes are located depending on the size of the state. Bigger ones, like California, have got bigger numbers compared to small states. But a president candidate must win more than 270 votes out of the total to be declared winner, which means the popular vote may not carry the day here. It is the college vote that matter. Election results are thus announced, and the president is sworn in January the following year. Functions of the U.S. government. The U.S. government are two levels. We have federal government of the U.S. and state government. We look at the federal government first. Federal government levy taxes. They pay foreign debts. They provide common defense. Declare war or peace. Maintain the armed forces, regulate commerce, and make and regulate issuance of the US currency, the dollar. It is in charge of foreign affairs or relations and formulate federal laws, plus establishing federal courts. These are the functions of the US federal government. Then as we proceed with the functions, you realize that they can allow a new state to join the union. They can establish the federal postal system and dismiss a federal government officer, including the president. They can amend the federal constitution and mediate disputes between different states. They give grants to member states and under their use. Plus, lastly, they make laws on naturalization and bankruptcy. Those are the roles of the federal government. I'm saying, the Republican governments, also called state governments, authorize the establishment of local governments. They formulate Republican or state laws. They run their own internal affairs, which may range from health, education, and public welfare. State governments also raise revenue locally from local income sales, exercise taxes, and property rates. Thank you so much. In our next lesson, we are going to continue with government of the U.S. Thank you so much and God bless you.